Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss about the topic from the transmission lines and RF system and transmission lines and waveguides. So the topic is reflection losses on the transmission line. Okay, so in the previous videos, we discussed the voltage and current equation of the dissipation-less line, then standing wave ratio, then how to measure input impedance, then how to measure load impedance, and how to measure power measurement, how to obtain in the transmission line, we discuss. So today we are going to discuss about the reflection losses. Okay, so already you know what is mean by reflection. The part of incident wave again reflected back to the sender, it is called as a reflection. So in which condition we will get reflection? If the load impedance, okay, the load impedance is not equal to the characteristics impedance of the transmission line, means at the time reflection takes place. Okay, so reflection takes place whenever the load impedance ZR is not equal to Z0. Okay, ZR is not equal to Z0. Characteristics impedance Z0 means we may get reflection. Okay, so due to this reflection, so some of the wave again reflected back to sender. So this is called as a reflected wave. So because of this reflection, so the not full power is delivered to load. So that is said to be reflection loss. Okay. So because of this unmatched transmission line, all the transmitted power will not be delivered to the load, and part of the power reflected back to the source. Okay. So the combination of, already you know, the combination of incident wave and a reflected wave, it gives rise to standing wave. Okay. So if in a perfect matched transmission line, means the standing, there is no standing wave. Only incident wave is there. There is no reflected wave. Okay. So the standing wave ratio for a matched line is 1. But if the line is not matched, means at the time only we will get reflection. Because of reflection, we may get reflection loss. Okay, so we are going to discuss about how much reflection happening in a transmission line. So first one, so you know, the maximum voltage is attained when the incident and reflected wave are in phase. Okay, so already you know, the maximum value of voltage in a standing wave system, the maximum voltage, this Vmax, it is attained whenever the incident wave and the reflected wave are in phase. Okay, so since if the two waves are in phase, means at the time only the two waves are added. So that's why we may get so Vmax can be written as, it is the addition of the incident voltage plus reflected voltage. Okay, so the modulus of Vmax can be written as, it is the addition of incident wave and reflected wave. Okay, and you know the formula for Vmax, already this Vmax we derived in the previous derivation. Okay, so previous power measurement, we derived this Vmax value. It is IR ZR plus Z0 divided by 2 into 1 plus modulus K. Okay, similarly, the minimum voltage is attained when the incident and reflected wave are in out of phase. Okay, so already you know, the incident wave and reflected wave are in out of phase, means at the time the standing wave reaches minimum voltage. So the minimum voltage, it can be written as, if out of phase means the two signals are subtracted. So minimum, it can be written as, it's a subtraction of the incident voltage and reflected voltage. So Vi minus Vr. So the Vmin value, already you know, the same IR is ZR plus Z0 by 2 into 1 minus modulus K. Okay, so from that, we are going to derive the standing wave ratio. So as per the formula for standing wave ratio, so you know what is standing wave ratio? We discussed this thing in the previous video. So the standing wave ratio is nothing but, it's a ratio of maximum voltage in the standing wave system divided by the minimum voltage. So what is the maximum formula? What is the Vmax formula in terms of this incident and reflected? It is the addition of incident voltage and reflected voltage. Okay, so here you see, similarly, what is V minimum? It's a subtraction of difference between incident voltage and reflected voltage. So V min can be written as Vi minus Vr. Okay, so this is the standing wave ratio. So similarly, next one, the power delivered. So similarly, the power delivered, P can be written as, already this power formula we derived in the previous thing. So the power measured on the transmission line is, modulus of Vmax into modulus of Vmin divided by Z naught. Z naught or R naught. Okay, so for dissipation less line, Z naught is R naught. So modulus of Vmax into modulus of Vmin divided by R naught. So you just substitute this Vmax and Vmin value here. So what is Vmax? It's addition of incident and reflected voltage. What is Vmin? Subtraction of Vi minus Vr divided by Z naught. So you just multiply these two things in the formula A plus B, A minus B. So we can written as A squared minus B squared by Z naught. So incident voltage squared minus reflected voltage squared divided by Z naught. Okay. So here, if you are separating this, okay. So if you are separating this, we may write Vi squared divided by Z naught minus V R squared divided by Z naught. So what is mean by Vi squared divided by Z naught? It is said to be power, incident power Pi. And what is Vr squared divided by Z naught? This is the reflected power. So Pi is the transmitted power and Pr is the reflected power means. So this total power P. So this total power P can be written as it's a difference between incident power and reflected power. Okay, so this part, it is a Pi. This Vr squared divided by Z naught is a Pr. So the subtraction of incident power and reflected power, it is said to be the power delivered to load. Okay, so you know, if you are transmitting some 100 watts power from the sender means due to impedance mismatch, only we will get 80 watt power in a load. So what about the remaining 20 watt? It is reflected back to the sender. So that 20 watt power is nothing but reflected power. This 100 watt is nothing but incident power. This power delivered to the load is 80 watt. So the 80 is equal to 100 minus the reflection 20. So power delivered to the load is equal to difference between incident power and reflected power. Okay. Then the next one, in order to measure how much amount of reflection loss is happening in a transmission line, we are going to find the ratio, the power delivered to the load to the power transmitted by incident wave. So P divided by Pi. So what is P? The P is nothing but Pi minus Pr divided by Pi. So Pi by Pi, it is 1 minus Pr divided by Pi. So what is Pr? So Pr can be written as modulus of Vr squared divided by R naught. Similarly, Pi can be written as modulus of Vi squared divided by R naught. So R naught cancel means we can written as 1 minus modulus of Vr squared divided by modulus of Vi squared. Okay, so you know what is reflected voltage divided by incident voltage? The reflected voltage Vr divided by the incident voltage. It is nothing but a reflection coefficient K. Okay, so already this reflection coefficient K we discussed in the first unit. Okay, so Vr divided by Vi is nothing but standing wave reflection coefficient. So Vr by Vi the squared can be written as K squared. Okay, so this is a one more formula. Then if you are substituting the value of reflection coefficient in terms of standing wave ratio, so you know what is the formula for K? K is nothing but S minus 1 by S plus 1. So if you are substituting, then if you are taking LCM, we will get the answer is 4S by S plus 1 the whole squared. So power delivered by the incident power ratio in terms of the standing wave ratio is 4 into S by S plus 1 the whole squared. Okay, so for this, how much power reflected in terms of standing wave ratio from this equation. So for various standing wave ratio, we derived this power delivered divided by power delivered to matched line. Okay, so if you are drawing the graph, so you see if the standing wave ratio is 1 means how much power delivered? The power delivered is 100%. Okay, that means in which condition the standing wave ratio becomes 1? In a perfect transmission line. Okay, in a matched transmission line. Matched transmission line means the ZR equal to Z naught. Whenever the ZR equal to Z naught, there is no reflected wave. So there is no reflected wave means the 100% power, okay, is transmitted to the load. Okay, then you see if the standing wave ratio increases means what about the power delivered to the load? It is decreases. Okay, and finally, if the standing wave ratio, it reaches the maximum value, the power delivered to the load reaches the minimum. So this graph indicates the ratio of power delivered to the load to the power transmitted as a function of SWR. So from this graph, we can say that if the standing wave ratio is minimum, means the maximum power is delivered to the load without loss. Okay, if the standing wave ratio is maximum, means there is a reflection loss is more. Okay, the power delivered to the load, it decreases. Okay, so this graph indicates the reflection loss as a function of standing wave ratio. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel, and please subscribe my channel for more videos. If you want to learn the transmission lines and RF system lecture videos, as well as the transmission lines and RF system MCQ videos, so in my channel there is a separate playlist is created for the two thing. Okay, in transmission lines and RF system for lecture videos, transmission lines and RF system MCQ playlist for MCQ. Okay, or I will give link for those remaining first unit and second unit videos in the description box. You can refer it. Okay, so thank you. We will meet in the next video.